Here we are in our last highlight reel. It's been my honor. I want to thank all the artists and all the donors of all these beautiful pieces, because through your donations, we make Matrix work. It's an important fundraiser, and there's still time to bid. Bidding on great pieces like Judy Bowman's work. Item number 111, called Mom on Seneca. Judy is incredible, just incredible. She's an exploding artist on the national scene, and I think you can see why. Vivid colors of everyday life. You know, Judy is an eyewitness to the everyday life. She's a crystal clear chronicler of joy, of slouching, of music, of people, of cards, of food. And she brings the life that was on the east side of Detroit and her family tree to all of us and shows the richness of family life. I love her work. We have a piece of her work that just brings smiles every time we pass. And I know that this piece would of yours. This is Mom on Seneca, Judy Bowman, item number 111, color and depictions and joy beyond belief. Our next piece is from Meighen Jackson, a strong supporter of the Artworks program. This is item number 136, called Ricketts Glen 24. The lines in here that pulse and dance and writhe like a waterfall. Well, in fact, it is of a waterfall at Ricketts Glen, which is one of the prettiest parks in Pennsylvania and one of the most scenic areas. Its name actually was Colonel Robert Ricketts. He was in charge of the Battery F in the Battle of Gettysburg at the Civil War. And so they saw his courage, and they had a waterfall and a state park named after him. And Meighen Jackson visited there and absorbed it and brought us this beautiful drawing. Meighen Jackson has a resume par excellence and is noted throughout the country for outstanding work. She's given us some outstanding pieces in the past, and this certainly is one. So please bid on item number 136. You'll be bidding against me because I like this piece that much as well. Meighen Jackson, great artist. What I love about this event is that Matrix knows art. It knows that art inspires people, and it tells us about life. And it also knows the power of art, that it can raise important funds for important causes. Like this piece from John McLaughlin called Huron River. John takes us on a meandering journey through the Huron River. I'm sure all of us have canoed it. Havener's Canoe Rental, of course. But this takes us on a path and throws in all those things that we would see through the Huron River experience or experiences. You know, that river goes 130 miles, starts up in Springfield Township in northern Oakland County, and dumps out into Lake Erie. But along the way, there's a lot of experiences and joys and discoveries that can be had. And if you look closely at this piece, you're going to see a lot more. Probably for a lifetime, you will see things in this piece. It actually has, there's a term called pale incest. And what it is things are erased in this piece and then written and painted over. But those, you still can see the background of them, and it tells interesting stories in that way. So this is item 143, Huron River by John McLaughlin. A very interesting discovery is yet to be had by you and your family if you are the successful bidder for this piece. Here's a fun piece we haven't seen in a few years. Kaiser Suidan's jacks. We've got four jacks that are just very cool pieces. A lot of people will place these on tables or hang these on walls. And you may have seen these on the Will and Grace set. They appear there. You may have seen them at the Cosmopolitan Hotel in Las Vegas. They appear there. They're also, they're in a variety of places. You may have seen them in Architectural Digest because they're frequently shown in, you know, beautiful rooms around the country in there. Kaiser Suidan is one of seven children, a Lebanese family. He grew up gardening. He liked soil. He liked clay, probably because he dug down deep in the sandbox to find the clay. He worked in ceramics. He got educated. He got scholarships. He created a career. He owns a gallery. He mentors people. And he's a strong friend of Matrix Human Services, and that's what we're most proud of and happy about. Please bid on item number 168, four jacks, ceramic, gorgeous colors that are complementary, that can fit your artistic room and your artistic skill in any way that you might want. Thank you, Kaiser. Our next item is a donation from Robert Sestok. Robert Sestok's item is number 162, called Spring in Siberia. I communicated with him this week. He'd never traveled to Siberia, except in his mind, so it's a very inexpensive trip that you could take as well. This is a powerful piece, though. It really is. A powerful piece of, explosive grays and blacks amidst the white. It speaks to us, and he says that he likes to create art that holds our attention for mysterious reasons. And I would say that this does, because you can look into it and you can see perhaps a reflection of one's soul. And that's another thing that he believes art is all about. His work is constantly evolving. Item number 162, Spring in Siberia, Robert Sestok. Thank you again. Here's another super piece. That was a donation from Linda Whitaker. Thank you, Linda. This piece is from a Louisiana artist, Frank Kelley Jr., who has a strong national following. He does gorgeous pieces. If you look closely at this work, you'll see a hugely textured piece. The brush strokes bring in great colors of golds and greens and blues. This piece is called Into the Sea. It's item number 232. He's shown at the Charles Wright Museum, amongst a number of other museums around the country. This is a strongly collected artist. We're fortunate to have him as part of the collection, and you'll be more fortunate if you're the winning bidder for item number 232, Into the Sea by Frank Kelley Jr. Our next highlighted piece is from Ron Parent, item number 151, called The Ridge. What Ron is famous for is abstracting landscape, and this is a pretty cool piece. It leads us up to the edge, close to danger, but not endangering ourselves. Interesting colorization throughout the piece, and maybe what's most important about this piece from a collector's standpoint is the Kresge Foundation purchased three of his works recently for part of their permanent collection. So beat the Kresge Foundation by bidding on this item and placing it in your home. Ron Parent, item number 151, The Ridge. The last item we're going to highlight is a piece from West Bloomfield resident Ellen Stone. Ellen was a psychotherapist who's turned to another medium instead of words to talk about emotions and people, and that's this piece called The Gift. The Gift is a very textured piece, and you might look at this and you wonder who's giving and who's receiving. Is the woman receiving the gift of flowers, or is she giving it to the man? It's a folksy, primitive figure which Ellen is known for. Her house is a gallery in and of itself. She's a very generous person to the arts, and we're thankful for her generosity to Matrix Human Services. But you know, she raises an interesting point, and that is there's joy in giving. So whether it's the man receiving or the woman receiving, whoever receives a gift, the act of giving receives the gift is happy, but actually the person who gives the gift is even happier. And that brings us to a close for Matrix Human Services. I'd like you to bid on this item, item number 166. But more than that, I'd like you to give. I'd like you to bid in the final hours that we have before the auction closes. Survey through the website. You are going to see, as we've shown through the last several days, some of the most outstanding art any person could ever purchase at very reasonable prices. But the price is not the thing. The price is what Matrix Human Services does for this community. It makes our community stronger. It provides help for people in need, and there are people in need. So be a part of the solution, be a part of giving, feel better, give from the heart, and give thanks to all the artists and everyone who's donated. It's truly been my honor to be a part of this enterprise once again. I hope I see you again next year, and I hope I see your name as a winning bidder. But don't worry, even if you're not a winning bidder, you can be a winning giver by donating to Matrix Human Services. Thank you. Good night. I'm Gregory Bator, signing off until next year.